Hey everyone, Trigonite here. So this is episode 8 of my Destiny Zer series, where we go to either the Reef or the Tower and just check out what the Agent of the Nine has to sell for the week. So he is located down in the bottom right as soon as you spawn into the Vestian outpost. So let's check it out.
I'm an agent.
Alright, so to get started, Legacy Ingram is just a year 1 armor piece or weapon. And this week he is selling the gauntlets. I do not believe in, and never have, paying 29 strange coin for it. Now, if it was a exotic Ingram, you could get the Ingrams, open them, stock up for like an Ingram opening video, you know, something like that, if that's, you know, what you're trying to do. But like for this, there's really no purpose in doing that. If it was a exotic Ingram, however, though, it could drop up to 400 light. So just keep that in mind. This will not. I think it drops up to 170 light. So, yeah. All right. Next is the Titan's armor piece for the week, which is Eternal Warrior. It grants gain unstoppable for the Fist of Havoc. So that just makes you harder to kill whenever you're coming in for your smash. A lot of people used to run it. It kind of faded away. It wasn't as useful or as used because they just ran the perk. But if you want to run Unstoppable, then you can run one of the other two things in that category, which I believe is Juggernaut or Titan's Gate. I'm not familiar with the Titan class very much, so I could be completely wrong. But I believe Unstoppable, Shoulder Charge, and Juggernaut Shield are the three in that far right category. So if you had Unstoppable, then you would be able to use Shoulder Charge or the Titan Shield and just be a little bit more tanky and stuff for PvP. So it's much more of a PvP, PvE, you're probably not going to have to run into it. There's a lot better armor that's PvE specific that you can run for the Titan. However, if this is you know, something you really, really like because of the you know, the visual look of it, then you might, you know, you might want to go with it. It's not a bad choice, but I would say it's more PvP. All right, next is the Lucky Raspberry. It's for the Arcblade, the Blade Dancer class, and Arc Bolt Grenade chains further and respawn with a full grenade energy. So overall, Lucky Raspberry isn't bad. I think Tarantella is probably the best if you're going to run a Blade Dancer and you want to run something that helps your super, because it increases the duration of Blade Dancer. This doesn't. So your Arc Blade doesn't affect your Arc Blade at all. It affects your grenades. And if you don't run the Arc Bolt Grenade, then it doesn't help you at all. Personally, I think the Skip Grenade is probably the best in the class if you like stickies, because they're freaking way overpowered and need to be nerfed. Then the Flux Grenade's not a bad choice, and the Arc Bolt Grenade's the last choice, and I believe, you know, that a lot of people don't run that as much as they probably run the Skip or even the Flux. Arc Bolt might be second, a little over Flux, but Skip dominates as far as the choice of grenade for the class, so not a huge help on that, but it's a decent armor piece for the week, as is the Eternal Warrior. So decent armor pieces for the week, but I believe that they're both PvP related. Next, we get into the Warlocks, which is the Purifier Robes, activating Radiance from the Death disorients nearby enemies. This could be useful for either PvP or PvE, but probably a lot more for PvP. So if you have somebody, such as, you know, this weekend in Trials, you have somebody watching your, you know, your res and your self res, because like they're like, okay, well, you know, we got the self res down, then you can res up disorienting them. I think it's within like 10 meters, I think, or something. Like if they're like a decent you know, distance from you, it's not gonna really do anything unless it like blinds, or won't blind them, but unless it like creates a light around you that makes you hard to see and you could try to get out of there. But I'm pretty sure it's more just like on their screen, they'll get a, you know, like a flashing light, like, you know, light up on their face due to this armor piece. I've seen people get res sniped even though they have this on. Giggs actually was the person. I've seen a video of him res sniping somebody in the face when they had the Purifier Robes. So it's not a bad class, and I'm running Warlock right now, so you'll be able to see what it looks like. It obviously looks super sick, super, super sick. It's got like the neck piece. You can maybe see it from here, but like the neck piece behind it, it's like one of the coolest looking armor pieces. It really is. But you know, I play in sweats, and you know, you don't do exotic armor, so I'm not gonna really worry about running it. If I ran any exotic, it would be for trials purposes only, and that's the Light Beyond Nemesis, because I think that is one of the most awesome looking armor pieces in the entire game, and I'm running a warlock now, maining one, so that's pretty cool. And then the weapon for the week. Lastly, I think this is more of a PvP, but could even potentially be used in PvE. However, I think that the Radiance class, the Sun Singer, is underused now. It's not really as frequent. You don't see it as much. But if you are a Sun Singer, then yeah, this is actually a pretty good armor piece for you. But you might not want to run it if you're, into sweats. And if you are, then fine. You could still run it in Crucible and PvE. Next, guys, is the Hard Light. I had a feeling that they would either put the Hard Light or even the Trespasser or the Surge Regime, something. Well, I think Surge was actually last week. I don't know. I'll check on my video. Anyways, so they recently just had the Sandbox patch come out and 2.5.02 or some shit like that. And anyways, guys, so was one of the big things and changes in this update was that auto rifles had an extreme buff. Now, I got killed last night playing Crucible after Rue got off. I played a lot of Rift. I probably got killed like a half a dozen times by an auto rifle from, longer than 25, 30 meters. I kind of sat back and I just thought about it and I was like, that's kind of annoying. Now, this is a Zer video. This isn't, a recap video of what I think about the update or anything, so I'm not going to spill on into it. But I just think the auto rifles got an unneeded buff. They hadn't been relevant for a while, but if you were good with them, then you could be good with them. If you knew which ones to use, you could be good with them. You can go back and watch any of my Zer videos, and if auto rifles come up at all, the number one thing I'll say is I believe that in order to be competitive in sweats, you need to be running hand cannons or pulses. Scouts are okay, and auto rifles only if you're running what? Four weapons, guys. Doctrine, Doctrine Adept, Vision Stone, Vision Stone Adept. Now, there's a lot of other good auto rifles out there, such as the Hard Light. It was one of the first guns I ever rocked whenever I was new to this game and I didn't understand how it operates. Surge Regime was actually the first gun I rocked on a consistent basis. Hard Light was second. I also rocked the Mita Multi-Tool when I finally got it and was extremely happy about it. It had a glory phase for a while there, and I came in at the end of it rocking the Mita, but then it kind of phased out when high rate of fire pulse rifles came in, and I went with that for a while. I didn't capitalize on getting the Clever Dragon, so I moved into the hand cannons, and that's where I'm currently at. So I don't believe that auto rifles should have gotten that buff. I believe that they're extremely easy to use. I mean, look at the stability. It's like 75% there, 80% there. This weapon is amazing. I've used it before. And then when you consider some of the perks they come with, like Surge has a perk that gives you back health. This has glass half full. So like the last 20 shots of this bullet or this clip are going to be more powerful bullets. They're going to probably be, like around 15 to 20%, probably about 20% of the impact out rather than just this 10. Then you got the Violate Light, which awesome perk. So if people just basically they get rewarded for sucking with this gun. So if you're a new player, I definitely suggest you take advantage of this, especially with the way that the update has made auto rifles more, useful, and take advantage of this. This allows bullets to ricochet off hitting the target. So like you could seriously miss if you were firing at a target and there was a wall right behind him, you missed some shots, those bullets are gonna hit off that wall and come back and hit him for minor damage. So it's like you can't miss shots with this gun because even the ones you do miss are gonna have a chance to come back and hit the opponent unless you're shooting at someone in the middle of like an open area. Scopes aren't bad. This one actually even gives it a little bit more impact, and you don't really need that stability and rate of fire or stability and range. But if you wanted to, you could just stay with the Accurized Ballistics, but Aggressive's not terrible. It's just not something that you'd want to. I mean, if you're going to be planning on getting up close every single time, then yes, definitely look into that because you might as well if you're going to get up close anyways. You don't need the range. Stability, I feel like it's already decent enough, and the impact, you get a buff in that. And you could even go back with you don't really need quick draw on an auto rifle, so you could go with fitted stock to get that hit that you lose in stability back. So you're really only losing range, gaining some impact, and you can run glass half full as well as violet light, and it's just ridiculous, dude. Like, you shouldn't need, an auto rifle to be good in this game, and the fact that they gave him a buff, that's another rant for another day. But anyways, guys, moving on. So recapping, yeah, I mean it's a good weapon if you want to be honest, but it's not going to be competitive in sweats. It's not going to be, something that, you should run. You want to play the meta, run it, whatever. Next, we got the vehicle vehicle upgrades, plasma drive, and emerald coil. I tried to say vehicle drives. I don't know why. Anyways, heavy ammo sense as well as 3 and 10. Not bad. I don't know how low I am, so I'm gonna pop that on that. Next, guys, got some glass needles, 3 a coin as always, and at the bottom the Motolite and the exotic shards. So, anyways, guys, always take advantage of those 3 a coin as they have a chance to increase your chance for exotic. Exotic shards, if you're looking to infuse some exotics, trying to get those up to 400 lighter, wherever, then definitely take advantage of that. And the glass needles are never bad if you do run exotic armor and you want to change some of the properties of them. All right, guys, as always, thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you next time, and I'll see you in the Crucible. All right, guys, thank you.
Only take what you understand.